Hello students, today we are starting a new chapter quite relevant to modern times, and this chapter is based upon degradation of Mother Earth. The present scenario of India is highly deplorable, as a report of Parliament's Estimates Committee highlights near catastrophic depletion of India's forest at the rate of 3.7 million acres a year. The article, The Ailing Planet, The Green Movement's Role, was written by Nani Palkiwala in the Indian Express on 24th November 1994. The Green Movement, a term that includes the conservation and green politics, is a diverse scientific, social and political movement for addressing environmental issues. Environmentalists advocate the sustainable movement of resources and stewardship of the environment through changes in public policy and individual behavior. In its recognition of humanity as a participant in ecosystem, the movement is centered on ecology, health, and human rights. What are the reasons? The reasons is mentioned. Mankind is now the number one cause of all the destruction happening on earth. As well as trying to destroy each other on the battlefield, we are the cause of a series of other disasters, beginning with the industrial exploitation of the resources of the earth. The seas and the oceans are being poisoned by chemical products, oils, industrial and human waste. On land, especially in the industrial countries where most waste is actually manufactured, there is increasingly little room to bury it, and even when buried, noxious elements leach out and destroy the health of the earth. Forests are cut down, but most of them are related to money or to people's need to provide their families. This has resulted in a widespread ongoing extinction of other species during the present geological epoch, now known as the Holocene extinction. The large-scale loss of species caused by human influence since the 1950s has been called a biotic crisis, with an estimated 10% of the total species lost as of 2007. The current rates include 30% of species at the risk of extinction in the next 100 years. In the present day, human activity has had a significant impact on the surface of the planet. More than a third of the land surface has been modified by human actions, and human use about 20% of global primary production. Earth's present condition is that it is in a damaged state and under threat from dangers, including those arising from global warming. These threats include greenhouse gases, droughts and floods, hunger and famine, and devastating diseases such as malaria and AIDS. Some expert scientists are calling for carbon taxes to cut the risk. Climate change is seen by some scientists to present the biggest threat to our world today, and we have to handle it. So, what is the future of the Earth? We can foresee it. Global warming will result in more hot days and fewer cool days, with the greatest warming happening over land. High latitudes and generally wet places will tend to receive more rainfall, while tropical regions and generally dry places will probably receive less rain. So, these are the effects, and scientists note with increasing concern the 21st century could see one of the greatest periods of mass extinction of species in Earth's entire history.